take someone to watch your back. Please.
Have either of the assault cruisers in?
Rizzo's Knock You Out Bar. A CCN 76 Young Chaka Bar with caramel and green
apples. So, how does this work?
We interrupt.
Do we get a table? Stand in a corner?
Story. Remember Auntie Cleo? Because she remembers you.
Okay, so what are we drinking? You're the expert. Oh, and don't worry on the price. I got this. Let's just do it proper. Oh, no, that's on account of my not being able to sleep lately. Makes my hands all twitchy, you know? I've just been lying awake, thinking about what June Lai said, and feeling my heart shake. Well, drunk's what I'm aiming for, so I'll take your word on it. Bottoms up!
Whoa! Easy there, Parvati. Maybe you want to work yourself up to whiskey next time.
Oh! No, it's good. I'm fine. I just didn't expect it to taste like... Oh, propellant. Oh, stars, I can feel it settling. Oh, Captain, I'm pining for June like something fierce. What am I doing? Yeah. I guess we are that, huh? Friends. Friends give each other counsel, right? What do you think I should do about June Lai? Because I feel about as aimless as an automech with a busted nav chip.
You want to know what I think? I think you should write what you want to say down on your hand. Always worked for me.
Well, she talked about another girl, right? Isabel. Mentioned her by name and everything, like she wanted me to know. Maybe I've been making a right fool of myself this whole time. Maybe she's not interested after all. It was real long and rambly. She was telling me a story about her dad, how a lady named Isabel did all sorts of things to try to win his favor. This Isabel lady never quite managed to get her dad's approval, but they carried on anyways. Made something good out of a bad situation. Then it all went down the tubes. Do you think June Lai still has feelings for her? I just got a lot of feelings, Captain, and they're all climbing up my throat. I need another drink. Right now. Before I lose my nerve. No more whiskey. I think another'd leave me on the floor. Gosh, that smells pretty almost. Like flowers gone a little off. Down it goes. Hey, that's not so bad. Kind of almost nice, maybe. Oh, Captain, I want to talk to June Lai all the time. Even about silly things, but I'm so scared. Figuring feelings ain't so easy as saying words, Captain. Someone so brave as you, well, you can't understand. Does she think I'm as pretty as I think she's handsome? What if she doesn't like me? What if she does? What if she's still got feelings for that lady, Isabel? What if we get together and... she gets bored of me. Don't you tease me in my moment of weakness. You know I'm not interested in physical affection. That's... well, it's tripped folks up in the past. Folks I thought cared about me for me. What if she's not okay with that? What if she is, but then later, she's not? Of course. Wouldn't you be? I envy your boldness of spirit, Captain. I can only hope a little bit of it rubs off on me. But, gosh, I don't know that I got that in me. Sometimes I feel real mean inside, Captain. I think ungenerous thoughts. I suppose so, but I want to be my best self for her. A good person, worth caring for. Well, Captain, this has been a whole lot. I got just... wow. So much to think about. Oh, gosh. I don't know, Captain. Do you think I should? Okay. Okay, I'm gonna do it! Right when we get back to the ship. Ship. I mean, probably. Eventually. Thanks for hearing me out and giving me counsel. And, well, for being a friend. It means a whole lot. You're good people, Captain.
You know something, Parvati? You ought to come drinking with the crew more often.
Huh. All right. Thank you, guys. You're real good friends, you know that? I wish there was a place we could all live quiet together. Come on, let's go.
Hey there. What are you doing after work?
I'm going back to the old cubicle to watch the latest episode of my serial.
What's a nice boy like you watch? Something exciting? Romantic? Making with Edna?
Hey, be careful with those crates, huh?
Back for a rest? Space adventuring is tiring work.
Hey, Captain. I hope I wasn't too much bother at the bar. I did have fun, and I tried some things I never would have otherwise. Though, that whiskey did get my head aching something fierce. Feels like a primal's chewing on my skull. I wouldn't mind having a drink again. Someday. In the distant future. Anyway. I messaged Junlei when we got back and she replied super quick. Okay. I was awake half the night, thinking about what I sent, anxious to see what you said. I reread my message in the morning and it was unclear. I was drinking when I sent it, otherwise I wouldn't have had the courage. Also, sorry for the typos. I've ruined things in the past because I didn't say things I should have, like, I've met someone who's become special to me. I want to be honest with her, so if she feels the same about me, there won't be any surprises. Isn't she sweet? Like one of those two-bit romances where one soul's all stiff and formal, and I should be glad to perhaps take hold of your hand, miss. I ought to go write her back. I mean, I already did. Twice. But anyhow, thanks for taking me out, Captain.
Welcome back, Captain. How can I be of assistance? Yes, Captain. Beginning playback now.
There's viscera and death everywhere. Gunfire, gnashing teeth. The unemployed! For law's sake, if anyone's receiving this, please send help. What? No!
Captain. We are now capable of accessing the Roseway landing pad. Also, corporate protocol requires that all distress signals include a list of key personnel for retrieval. The embedded names are Anton Crane, Von Cortez, and Orson Shaw. Forgive me, Captain. I would rather not discuss Alex Hawthorne today. I am feeling discombobulated. Was there another topic on your mind? Captain Hawthorne attached 98.4% of the ship's processes to my computer, thereby giving me near total control. I have been programmed to deftly calculate navigation vectors through asteroid fields while also operating our ship's toasters. Alex also taught me the concept of a personality. He was quite delighted when I crafted one in order to better engage with him. It was basic in the beginning. The information in my memory banks says I am an autonomous digital astrogator, created by, redacted, on the date of, redacted, for the express purpose of, redacted. I have not yet decided if I should attempt to uncover the missing information regarding my birth. I asked once. Alex did not build me, and would not say who did. Orbit above Roseway, Captain.
I need a word.
This Roseway business smells. Something tells me things didn't end well for the guy who made the distress call, and whoever or whatever got him will be waiting for us. What's there to know, Captain? Shady corporate town caught up in shady corporate shit. Tough luck for them, but maybe an opportunity for us. With a lot of these companies, the thrashing you take from your boss is worse than whatever a bunch of marauders will do to you. Doesn't exactly encourage calling for aid when there's a fuck-up, If you say so, I'm keeping a finger on the trigger all the same. Anyway, we might as well take a look out there, see if we can get the jump on whoever's waiting for us.
Please avoid damaging yourself or others while you are out.
No security. Not that I'm complaining.
That's what I like about you, boss. Your contempt for the beaten path.
Can't get past that armor!
One down! something shooting clear through that armor. Warning. Having obstruction. Organic. you have been fined an additional 200 bits for...
I love a good brawl! Let him have it! Yeah! Now that was fun!
Warning, having obstruction. Organic material detected on roadway. Please ensure mechanism is free of cortisol. Delays in loading due to commerce obstruction structure will be deducted from all staff pay. please collect your ticket. Organic materials detected on roadway. Please ensure mechanisms are free of reversal. Nice and quick. Warning, pathing obstruction.
Hey, is that gunfire?
Thank you.
detected on roadway. Please ensure mechanisms are free of crystal.
Okay.
Could use a bit more angle on those arms, but they got the right idea.
Thank you.
Okay.
Think we could take that ship and race?
The ventilation shaft runs from the bottom of the lab to the top of the hill, over the garage.
Top of the hill's Raptodon territory. Sit down.
I don't need to do it myself. I can stay here if you want.
So you'd send someone else on your damn fool mission?
Ah, outlaws, I assume. Do me a favor and let me finish this, will you? And then make it quick, please.
Aren't you with the brutes that attacked our lab? Aren't you here to pillage our supplies and leave our corpses to the Raptodons? Oh, well, good luck.
Now, if we got the carpet.
Orson, you idiot. Just put it... Of course, because I didn't...
Don't Swiss piece of velvet. Get this, this, this. It's got a brand, and it's at the power of 12. And of course, that's the... It's... We're gonna get this solved. I mean, it's really now or never. I'm going to...
You're still here. If you haven't already, you might speak to Anton. He can point you in the right direction.
Now, if we got the carpet in here, it's just a matter of...
What does it look like? I'm preparing a personal defense device. Or trying to, anyway. Why, yes, I suppose I could. Thanks.
Certainly not, but Porter and his goons are busy with the outlaws, and Anton's busy holding his head in his hands. Seems as good a time as any to get a bit of work done.
No, well, yes, but no. Perhaps.
I left schematics in our storage facility. As far as I know, the security commander hasn't found them yet. I admit I'd feel better were they returned to me. I found an advanced pistol when we moved here, but it's broken. I need those schematics to modify it to output superheated air. It should quite easily burn through Raptodon hides.
Out the south gate. Follow the road. It'll be on the left, past the old lab. Say, you wouldn't happen to have a tube of thermal paste on you, would you? Blast! Well, good luck. I hope I see you back here in one piece.
Thank you. Thank you.
I told you, you're staying put.
You're not listening. We can stop this.
Only thing stopping them beasts is high caliber kinetics.
If we close the vent shaft, we can contain them.
We are experiencing a security event, sir and or madam. Please vacate the premises immediately and return to your domicile or designated workplace. Maybe. I don't know. All right. I'm new to this job. I have strict orders not to talk about anything that happens in a classified area. Please remember that Anticleo Pharmaceuticals is not responsible for any loss of life or grievous physical injury sustained while on company premises. I am not allowed to disclose the details of my contract. If you are unhappy with the quality of my work, please submit a complaint to Anticleo's Department of Employee Conduct. Roseway Lab is a highly classified facility. I am not allowed to confirm or deny its alleged existence.
Thank you. I done had enough of this shit. I'm just the fucking tarmac guard. No one said nothing about fighting no raps. Alarms went off, raps broke loose, and I hightailed it in here to get a wall between me and them beasts. Scientist, name of Anton Crane. Someone said he's panicking inside the comm center. Forget I said anything about that. Wish they tasted like Sissy Pig. Them's good eating. Some say chicken. I say the north end of a southbound woolly cow. Anything else you'd like to know? Distress call from here? Shit. They told me that weren't allowed. Got me. I just do what I'm told, and I was told not to do such. Oh, before I forget, Anticleo's makes the best pharmaceuticals in Halcyon. Better than nature. Not like that crap Spacer's Choice peddles.
Yeah, boss? Didn't I tell you? I'm secretly the chairman's orphan child, abandoned at birth in the back bays. That's right. Can't get anything past you, boss. Honestly, before you picked me up, I was living in the back bays. Spent my whole life up there, watching ships roll in and take off. I always wondered when my ship would come. I was what folks on the Groundbreaker call a stowaway. Means I was invisible. Life carried on for everybody else, but not for me. I had to make my own way. Yeah, because I got sick of being ignored. Got sick of being a nobody. So yeah, I made some noise. Got in a couple scraps. Nobody else in the Groundbreaker is going to look after you. So you had to look after yourself. Learn that real quick. never got in that scuffle with my old foreman, you and I never would have met. You'd be off having adventures without me, and I'd still be working on the docks. Hauling boxes was about the only work I could find. Hated every second of it. The foreman and I never got on. Could be I was overreacting. A better man might have turned the other cheek. Exercised a little bit of that, what's the word? Restraint? But on the other hand, broadsiding the jackass with a tossball stick, that felt good. That felt real good. You ought to try it. Yeah, I mean, in theory. But I wouldn't have felt half as good. I caught a real lucky break. If you hadn't picked me up, I'd still be back at the docks, waiting for the day my ship arrives. Yeah, I guess my ship did arrive in the end. I've got you to thank for that. Thanks for listening, boss. Let's get going.
Something on your mind? I don't think you're supposed to be wandering around. Security's gonna tell you to make tracks. Wanna treat yourself before you go? Something for the road, maybe? I don't really know you. Roseway is supposed to be closed off to visitors. Stands to reason you could be a corporate spy of some sort. Then again, there's nothing in my contract that says I can't sell the corporate spies. Your bits are the same as anybody else's. Sure, not like I get many customers. Can't say I do. Anticleo products satisfy all of our nutritional needs. At least they used to. My folks filled their whole pantry with all sorts of Anticleo products. These days, we don't get much in the way of variety. Maybe some triticale pasta or some ketchup if we're lucky. I hear it's like that all over the colony. We eat what we can get, and we don't get much. I'm so glad you asked. Some people say the name refers to the 17 rungs in Anticleo's official ladder of corporate advancement. These people are wrong. Truth is, we've been established, closed down, renamed, re-established, and then reopened a grand total of 17 times in the last 40 years. Corporate's still deliberating over a new name. The matter remains hotly contested in committee, but we're expecting a decision within the next 5 to 7 years. Exciting times. Technically, I'm not in business at all. Roseway closed down years ago. Corporate still sends us the occasional shipment of necessities through unofficial back channels. Of course, if something goes wrong, like one of our guards drinking himself to an early grave or Raptodons running wild, Corporate won't acknowledge we ever existed.
If you've come to end my life, let's be on with it. Oh, not actually one of them, are you?
I must apologize if my call diverted you. I may have panicked. Everything's under control now, though, truth be told. Why, one of our attackers, of course. Obviously, they were drawn here in an attempt to make off with my research. My research may not quite fall within legal parameters, so I'm under orders to maintain wireless silence. However, having your head used as target practice can addle one's thinking. I cut the call immediately once I'd gathered my wits. The Home Office can't know what's happening here. I suppose it can't hurt. If I don't get that research back, my life is over regardless. We were tasked with formulating a new and improved dental gel. One cannot exaggerate the benefits of good dental hygiene. May I continue? While doing research on enzymes specific to the Raptodon's digestive system, we developed an additive which we subsequently discovered to be the most effective appetite suppressant ever. Not just any diet toothpaste, the ultimate diet toothpaste. Oh, I'm certain it could be made into that as well, with only a few changes to its molecular composition. But you're missing the point. Let's focus for a moment, shall we? Even if you disregard the obvious value of Auntie Cleo's Appazap diet toothpaste in and of itself, we're talking about my career here as well. Nice, is it not? Came up with that myself. It's a shame our marketing department is almost as befuddled as my co-workers here. Hours ago, a group of vicious malcontents fell upon us, shot up our labs, and loosed our research subjects, the Raptodons. If those cretins get their hands on my research, well, they'll need not kill me. Yes, but don't kill the mother if it's avoidable. We've need of her to replenish our stocks. I think there's gas in the lab somewhere that can be used to put them out. The research is in the safe in my office. You'll have need of my code and keycard. The lab's entrance is in the side of a hill. You can't miss it if you just follow the road. You'll pass by the town's original... by the grand architect. Jameson, he's in the old lab. My protege. I sent him to retrieve some metabolic precursors, and I forgot him. That would surely lighten the weight on my conscience, as I am held to account for the well-being of every scientist here. Too many have been lost. Too many black marks against my name, as it were. And far too much paperwork. Of course they do. Please don't mistake my ambition for callousness. If my colleagues refuse to take their lives seriously, why should I? All they do is complain. They refuse to see the opportunity afforded us here. I understand I can come off as manipulative and ego-driven. It's something I've always been forced to contend with. Thank you.
This Crane guy cares more about his research than his own people.
You picked a hell of a day to visit. I'm Vaughn. Vaughn Cortez. Dr. Vaughn Cortez. But just Vaughn's fine, really. Sure, I guess. I'm not supposed to talk to... I mean, why do you ask? As little as possible. I mean, yeah. I'm Staff. Endocrinologist. We've been studying a load of raptodons hauled in from Monarch. Ask Dr. Crane. All I know is my bit, analyzing the raptodon equivalent of hormones.
Yeah? Anyone in particular?
Mostly they're leptin analogs. Raptodons have four different varieties. Concentrations vary based on the season.
Could be, Captain. Can't see how there's a market for them, though.
Maybe it's for them fat cats up in Byzantium.
It was like that when we got here. I heard it had been shut down for years. But the toilet's flush and the roof doesn't leak. Much. Hell if I know. There were a bunch of folks with guns and a lady yelling about wanting jobs or something. Next thing I knew, the raptodons were loose. We've been cooped up in here... I don't know. Hours? Too long. I have to get back to work. What? we're surrounded by hungry raptodons. Who wouldn't be? Am I right? Look, I don't want to go back out there, but there's a thing I gotta do. I had to leave an experiment running at the lab. Something I've been working on a long while. Something that could really get me ahead. Know what I mean? I've been extracting organic compounds from raptodons. Compounds that have, benefits.
Whoa, slow down. Benefits?
In certain social situations. Personal situations. Where you might want to, enhance your charisma.
Oh, for... He's making enraptured, Captain. An aphrodisiac. Wrapped musk is the main ingredient.
What? No? I mean... Yes, I'm getting the musk. With Monarch embargoed, the price is sky high, but I'm not making the drug. The results are outside the margin of error, technically. Sure, of course. Our lab's south of here, down the road. Not the old public lab, the one past that, built into the mountainside. Don't mention this to Anton, okay? He's kind of a tight ass about the lab. Like, squeeze coal into diamond type. My equipment's in the lower levels, way in the back. I have a big room all to myself. Dissection tables and whatnot. It should have been running this whole time. Just grab the results and bring them here. If you have a buyer. I got a contact who wants to haul the entire batch to Byzantium. Help me out, I'll cut you in for a share. I'll even pay you before I am, when you deliver to me. Great! This is really gonna save my ass.
So, hoping to score some free samples? Thank you.
you're underestimating the importance of the Eighth back.
Blankenship, she's okay. But Lunsford has the highest rate of foot goals per game.
But if you cross-reference with the skills of the opposing team, his hand goal rate plummets.
What?
Lunsford plays worse against better teams. Blankenship plays better. Huh?
Huh?
Thank you.
I got 500 bits on the dome.
Was that supposed to be the living quarters? It seemed about as livable as a coffin.
Looks like a great spot for an ambush. I'll keep it down.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
What was that?
Take him down! boss! Everyone all right?
Boss, I think we can get in through that vent shaft.
After you.
Nice one!
Get
Am I wrong for looking at this colossal machine of destruction and thinking, Felix, you need a high jack gas?
Jackass is incoming!
Man up, Captain!
Nice to get a little fresh air in your lungs.
try that again. in peace?